Hi, I'm Ben Marriott. I make weekly motion design and animation tutorials, and this week I'm going to show you how to make those lovely looping textures and all my tricks to use them efficiently. Let's begin. Now I've got three looping textures going on here. We've got this big one as a sort of a frame that goes around the edge, one inside the abduction beam, and then one that goes all over everything, this kind of little speckly overlay one. And we're going to focus on creating that texture there. Now the process is 100% the same for all of these textures, so by the end of this video you'll have the skills required to make all of these. Now a light texture like this speckly one here is really extremely useful. I think I use a texture like this in maybe 70 to 80% of all of my work. It does a few things. It mostly adds a sense of sort of physical media, which can help to obscure a slick sort of digital feeling that you can get with a lot of digital motion graphics that you don't always want, and add just extra sort of movement to your piece. If your scene is very static, this can just add a little more life to it as well. So let's go and delete this light texture layer here that I rendered out as a video, and let's go and make one from scratch. You can start by scanning in a piece of your own material. I've used this piece of textured paper, which I painted black. I made this a long time ago. Years and years ago, so once you make these ones, you'll begin using them for maybe the rest of your life. I use this piece of paper that I painted black roughly, and you can still see a lot of the texture of the paint in here as well. You can also photograph textures like concrete or wood to get different effects. Make sure you scan it into the high DPI so you can get lots of detail. Now let's make a new composition with Control N and call that light texture. And I'm gonna make this 4K so we can easily resize them. And let's make this 8 frames long. Now let's drag in your texture from over here. Trim this to 2 frames. So when I put my player at 1 frame and press Alt close square bracket to make this 2 frames long. Let's duplicate that with Command D and drag that over so it's in sequence. Now we're gonna change its rotation so it looks like a different texture from the first frames here. So let's press R to open up our rotation property and just drag that. Let's go to around 180, around there. There we are, and if we flick back and forth, to me that looks like a different texture, so that's great. And let's just do that 2 more times. And you might need to change the position as well, so let's just drag that around. There we are, and once more. There, now let's play that back. That looks pretty good to me. Now we're rotating them and changing the position. If you've got a texture that has some more recognizable features in it, this one doesn't have so much, but if you've got like really obvious brush strokes in unique shapes, you might wanna do maybe 2 versions or like take 2 photos or scans of different versions of that, just so when it comes in, it doesn't look like you've just rotated and changed the positions, which is what you've actually done, and that might help you there. Now I've done this so I've got 4 layers here. You can do this more, you can have, you know, 6, 8, however many you want. I think 3 should be about the minimum. Otherwise you can see the loop fairly easily and it kind of maybe breaks the immersion very slightly. I think 4 is a good amount. So let's see how we can use this looping texture in our main abduction layer. Here's our scene, let's drag in our light texture over the top here. First we need to loop this composition because after those 8 frames, it runs out. So let's right click here. Select time, enable time remapping on frame before the last keyframe. Let's make a new keyframe by clicking this over here, deleting this last keyframe, holding option, clicking the stopwatch, selecting this arrow, select property and loop out. And now if we drag this along, that texture should loop nicely. All right, now we're gonna need to scale that down. So let's bring up our scale property with S and drag that down so it kind of just fits the edge. Now let's select a blending mode to see our texture in action. Let's select screen, which will only show the light areas of the texture. And you can also select multiply, which will only show the dark areas of the texture. So let's do screen for now, and let's watch it back. All right, one thing I wanna do is slow this down because this is jittering far too fast for my liking. So we can right click, select time and time stretch, and change the stretch factor from 100 to 200. And that will stretch the layer out, so a higher number equals slower. Now let's play that back. All right, that speed's working for me now. Now we do want some more contrast in here because at the moment we have a lot of gray in our texture. So we're gonna add a curves effect. Now here's where we can control the amount of texture. Normally I wanna crush the blacks, so on a screen blending mode, a lot of the underlying animation will still show through. To do that, we drag this bottom handle here on our curves layer and drag it forward. So the original color underneath sort of comes in. And then we want to increase the whites as well. So I'm going to click in the middle of this curves layer here and just bring this up. There we are. Now we can kind of see more what we're working with. This is probably a little heavier than I want, so let's crush the blacks even more until we just get sort of these sort of speckly dots. Yeah, I think that's looking pretty good. Now let's play that back. And here, of course, you can tweak it to suit your own needs. And we didn't apply this curves layer inside our composition here because we want it to have as much control of it outside here. So we can use this same looping texture to create the speckle effect. And we could also use it to create a much more heavier effect as well by just changing the curves here. Now we want to use this same layer to create sort of a darker speckly effect as well. So to do that, let's duplicate our layer. And we're going to use this layer underneath this one. So we're going to select the blending mode multiply. Now you can see at the moment it's just cancelling it out. So what we want to do is invert this layer. So in our effects panel, we type in invert, select that, and it'll invert our layer. And because we've got our screen layer over the top here, it's kind of cancelling out. So if we rotate this layer by pressing R to bring up our rotation property and rotate it, let's go about 180 degrees. So it's flipped. You can see we've got these dark speckles now as well. So if we play that back, got both a dark and a light speckled happening here. Now, if you want these speckles to have their own color and not just use the multiply and screen layer to be, you know, black or white, there's two ways that you can do that. So let's hide these two layers and I'll show you that. First, we need to create a solid. So let's press Ctrl Y and let's select this pink color from our animation as well. Now we're going to duplicate this light texture here, place it over the top of our solid over here. Select the blending mode normal, and from this pink layer we're going to select the track mat luma mat. And luma mat takes the luminance property, the black and white of the layer above, to determine what's visible here. So now this pink layer is taking its opacity, its visibility, from the white layers of this layer up here. So now we get this nice pink speckles here. Now for method two, we're going to get rid of this pink layer and make our light texture layer visible again. And this one is going to use the effect VC Color Vibrance. This plugin is from Video Copilot and it is completely free, and it creates an alpha channel based on the blackness of your layer. And you can also use it to recolor the layers, which keep a stronger vibrance than just adjusting the hue on its own. So if we select alpha matte only, it's going to remove all the black from that layer. And let's add a fill effect from over here. Fill. And now we can select our pink layer, and we've got our colored speckled texture layer here as well, and you'll save a layer from using the other method. Now, if you want to use a texture on its own and not as an overlay layer, so it still maintains all its full texture and there's no opacity, similar to how I've got this frame in the side here, you can change its colors with the tint effect. So let's duplicate this layer here and let's get rid of color vibrance and fill. We can have the tint effect from our effects panel over here. Select tint, and tint will recolor your image in a duotone fashion, remapping a different color to black and one to white. So to select colors from your composition, let's hide this layer and we want to map the black to, let's say, this gray color here, and maybe we want to map white to this pink layer. Now if we turn that back on, you can see the black is now this gray color and the white is this pink layer. And if you adjust the contrast on this curve, you can see that more apparent. And you can also change the color down here to map it to any layer. And that comes in very handy for recoloring your textures. And that's exactly what I've done for these two other textures down here. Now, to speed up this process for the next time you use that texture, you can render out that texture file on its own in its own comp for maybe about 5-10 seconds, whatever you think it'll need. And the next time you want to use it, you can just drag it in and adjust the curves and effect you need from here. You won't have to go through the whole process again. Now, it's great to have your own textures that you've made yourself, but you can also buy pre-made looping textures such as a looper pack and grit kit. And maybe I'll make one of my own in the future. And I've bought these and used these before because it's really convenient. You can get textures without having to, you know, go out and photograph and scan them yourself, and just saves you a lot of time. And that's exactly what I've used for this scrumpled paper and this lined paper here. This brown paper one is just a scrumpled up piece of paper. So you could easily make that and scan that on your own. And for a UFO beam, I use this lined paper here. So both these objects are probably within arm's reach of you anyway. But my favorite and most used textures will always be my own. If you use anything you've learned in this video on your own work, please tag me at Ben_married_ and I'll share it in my stories. I can't wait to see what you make. Please let me know down in the comments what other videos you'd like to see from this channel. It really helps me choose what type of content to make next. And don't forget to subscribe.
hit that bell icon, share, and texture that like button with the clicks of your finger. I'll see you next week.